Hi, my name is Tina, and this is Knitting Blooms. You can find show notes for everything I talk about on my blog at www.knittingblooms.com. And if I miss a link, please feel free to contact me on Ravelry as Bloomingknitter. Or you can email me at knittingblooms@gmail.com. Come and join the Ravelry group so you can be eligible for all the prize drawings. And be sure to introduce yourself so that I can get to know you also. You can also follow me on Instagram and Twitter as Bloomingknitter. And don't forget to click the like button on Facebook for Knitting Blooms. In this video, I'm going to show you how to carry your yarn when you are using hand-dyed or kettle-dyed yarn. When you use two or more skeins of kettle-dyed yarn, it is important for you to alternate your skeins because it is unlikely that if the yarn is hand-dyed or kettle-dyed, that the skeins will be exactly the same. So if you have to change to a new skein in your project, you may find that there's a big difference either in colorway or color dye lot, or in, say, where your dark spots, such as this dark spot, shows up in your yarn. So that's what I'm going to show you today. I'm going to show you how to alternate your skeins so that you can have a seamless look when you are using two or more skeins of hand-dyed or kettle-dyed yarn. This first project I'm going to show you is my knit swirl that I'm currently working on, and I am carrying two skeins of yarn in my project to make sure that I don't have that harsh edge if I change my yarn, as I just mentioned. I am using the same yarn that I just showed you. I have 8 total skeins for this project, and I just want to make sure that I have that it looks like it was all one skein. So the way that I'm doing that is I'm alternating two different skeins every row as I work this knit swirl. Now, you will notice that at the beginning of this project, I was carrying my yarn up the back, which is the side that I'm showing you now. This project is worked in the round, and on this particular pattern, it is worked with the wrong side facing you. So I was carrying my yarn up the back of the sweater, up the inside of the sweater. Now you will see that there is a slight ridge on all of the reverse stockinette welts here, okay? But if you look at the stockinette welt, you barely even notice that there is a extra yarn being carried up there. So what I did was, after I realized that, I started carrying my yarn up the front side of the work on the reverse stockinette welt, so that when you flip it over, you can't really see it here, but when you look up here, you can't really see it there either. So that's what I started to do, because then my sweater is more versatile if I decide to flip it one way or the other. So in this case, I am carrying it up the front side of the work when I'm on my reverse stockinette welts, and the back side of the work when I have my stockinette welts. And I'm going to show you how to do that right here. Actually, I have to remove a few stitches because I'm a little bit past where I changed color. So the main thing is that I am doing here is I am changing on the same stitch on every round, meaning that every round I change right at my marker. Okay, that's the way I'm doing it. And if I wanted to do it differently, I could go one stitch past where I was where I had my last change. So if I didn't want to change at the same stitch every time, I would just go one past and then change. But let me show you the two different ways. So what the most important thing is that you cross your yarn each time, because if you don't cross your yarn, you're going to end up with a big gap between the stitches. So by crossing the yarn, you are going to kind of secure down the yarn a little bit and help keep those stitches together. So if you think about it like when you're weaving in your ends and you have to take one end one way and one end the other way to kind of keep those two edges together, that's kind of what we're doing here. So what we're doing is, this is the new yarn that we're going to be picking up, and this is the one that we just finished using. And what I suggest is that you cross your yarn the same way each time. So what I have been doing is I have been taking my current working yarn, crossing it over my other working, my new working yarn, and bringing my new working yarn up and around that other yarn. So it's capturing that old yarn in there. And because I am doing a stockinette stitch, I will bring my yarn to the back and then knit my first stitch. Now, you will notice that there's a pretty big gap, but still between those two stitches, okay? What you want to do is take this old yarn that is attached to this last stitch right before the stitch marker, and you're going to just give it a little tug, and that's going to bring that in. And it's okay to pull this stitch because, or pull this yarn, because that stitch is on your needle, and no matter how hard you pull it, it's only going to get as small as your needle. Okay, what you don't want to do is pull your new yarn that you're currently using, because if you pull this one too tight, what's going to happen is that the stitch below that this is coming from is going to shrink. And I'm going to try and show you without the stitch marker getting in the way. So if I pull this stitch too tight, actually it's not really going very far, but you don't want to pull that one too tight, because if you pull it too much, I'll just take it out here and I'll show you again. If you pull this yarn too much, what's going to happen? There we go. It's going to pull that stitch a little bit too small. And I don't know if you can really see that, but it did really shrink in that stitch up a lot. So we don't want to do that. We don't want to pull on the new yarn. Okay, so let me take it back to where I was before. So I just finished my last stitch on this side. And I'm going to, because I am carrying my yarn on the front side, or this is actually the back side, but I'm carrying it on the side that's facing me for the stockinette section. I'm going to bring my yarn to the front. I'm going to cross it over the new yarn. I'm going to bring the new yarn up and around to the back. And then I'm going to knit that first stitch. And again, I can take this old yarn and give it a little snug pull and make sure that it pulls that stitch tight. Okay, and then I can just keep working in the round. Now, I mentioned that the other option would be to work one stitch past where you previously did your join. And how you would do that is, here is where the other yarn is. And what you would do is you would knit one stitch past that yarn, and then you would bring this yarn back to the back and this yarn to the front and knit the next stitch. Now, okay, hopefully you'll be able to see this, but you see there's a cross. You see that yarn? It's hard to tell because it's the same color, but you see that yarn crossing over my stitch? See that there? And then it's also doing the same thing on the back, because I have to pull this one to the front. I did not like that look, which is why I chose to do the other method. So let me back it up again. Take this stitch out. This is why I chose to do the method of changing at the same stitch every time. So at my marker, I bring my working yarn to the front, over my other yarn, take my new yarn that I'm going to start working with, and bring it to the back, and then knit my first stitch. And then if I need to close a little bit of a gap here, I'm going to pull on the old yarn that I just finished working with that now is going to be on the resting. And then I can start knitting again with my new yarn. And that hole is sucked closed by giving this a snug. Now you may have to do that a couple times just to make sure that it closes up the way you want it to. But as long as you cross those yarns each time you come to them, you won't have any gaps. And again, on that stockinette side, you don't see that carry that I have here. Whereas when I was working down here on the reverse stockinette, you can kind of see where I carried that yarn up. Now again, this is the back side of the sweater, so it's going to be inside my sweater and it's not going to be seen. But I just wanted it to be completely seamless, which is why I switched to carrying the yarn up on the front side of the sweater when I did my reverse stockinette welts. So that is using two skeins of yarn working in the round. Now I'm going to show you using two skeins of yarn, and we're working flat. And in this particular case, I am doing a shrug, and this edge of my garment is going to be exposed. So I want to make sure that my carries up the side are nicely done. Okay, and you will see here that as we look at the edge, you have this twisted braid that goes up the side, and you see how nice and neat that is going up the side of this garment. And this is going to be nice for if you're doing a shawl or a shrug, that you need to have that nice edge going up the side. Now I'm going to show you how I did this. And again, like I mentioned with the last one, with the knitting in the round, and just like working in the round, you want to make sure that you carry your yarn up the same way each time. And that is how I got this nice little twisted braid up the back. So what I have done with this one is I have held, what I do is I take the working yarn, the one that's on the needle, and I just bring it to the back and hold, just kind of hold it there out of the way a little bit. And I pick up the new yarn. Now, when you're working flat, you don't have the benefit of having your previous stitch be on the needle. So what you don't want to do is you don't want to pull this new working yarn too tightly. You want to make sure that your stitch that you had previously stays intact and stays at the right size. But you also want to make sure that you pull it tight enough that you don't have big loops coming down the side of your garment. So what I've done, again, I slip my needle in, I just pull this a little bit, and I knit my first stitch, and then I make sure that I pull it tight enough without pulling the stitch below. I don't want to tighten that stitch below too tight. I just want to pull it just tight enough where it's going to gently bring that yarn up to that next row, and then I can continue. Because you want to make sure that you have this give in this edge, especially if you're going to need to block it. So again, let me back it out. I'll show you again. So I just take this yarn, and I kind of just, this is the yarn that's on the needle currently, and I just kind of hold it to the back. I just secure it with my hand, and I hold it there, and then I knit my first stitch, making sure not to pull that stitch. And if I find that I've pulled it a little bit too much, I can come back here. Oops, sorry. I can come back here and just give it a little tug to pull it out a little bit so that I know it's not too tight, and then I can continue to knit with it. So again, one more time, I'm going to show you. I just hold that one needle back, or sorry, that one yarn back. I stick my needle in, and I take the new yarn, making sure I have the new yarn, and knit the first stitch, and just pulling it tight enough to make sure that the stitch comes up, or to make sure the yarn is tight. But if I notice that I am pulling it just a little bit too tight, I can always just go back and loosen that stitch just a tiny bit before I continue. In this example, I am showing you how to carry 3 yarns up. And this would be done in something like the Color Affection when you're on the last section and you're using 3 different colors at one time. Again, just like the previous 2 projects, you want to make sure you carry your yarn in the same fashion every time. Now, I'm going to show you how I do this one, but before I do that, I want to show you the back again. Just like with the last project where you had a nice little braid up the side, you have that here as well. That's what we want to achieve. We want to achieve a nice little braid that's up the back side and is minimally noticed on the front side. You will never be able to completely eliminate seeing a little bit of carry on the front side. But that is the idea, is that you want to have minimal distortion on the front side. So what I have found with carrying 3 yarns is that, remember in the last one, I would hold the current yarn back, and then I would knit with the next yarn up and bring it to the front. But what I found with 3 is that it actually lies a little bit better when I pull the next yarn up, which is the bottom one from that's going to be coming up. When I pull it up behind the other yarns and get ready to knit with that, and then again tuck the other yarns a little bit so that I kind of can secure them just a tiny bit while I'm getting ready to knit this. And then I can start knitting with this next yarn. Again, I'm taking the 2 yarns that are not being used. I'm bringing the new yarn up behind. I found, again, if I hold these back and I bring this up forward, I'm finding that that carried yarn tends to land on the front of the work more, which is why I've decided to carry it up the back behind the other two colors, and then kind of hold those snug to the side and then knit that stitch. Again, you want to make sure you do that the same every single time, so the next time after I bring the yellow up and I'm working with the yellow, then I'm going to hold the two the yellow and the pink together and bring the blue up behind it. So each time I am twisting that yarn around, and again I'm creating that sort of a braid on the back of the work by doing that. And like I said, with three yarns, I did find that bringing it up behind worked so much better. It laid a lot nicer, and it just had a much more flat look versus if I carried it up the front like I had with the previous project. Again, just like with all of the other ones where I say don't pull the next yarn too tight, you want to make sure that you keep that a little bit loose when you pull that up and then snag those yarns behind. You want to keep that a little bit loose when you go to knit that first stitch, because you don't want to pull those stitches from below, and you want to have a nice edge on your project. So that's how you knit with 3 colors. I hope you enjoyed this tutorial, and I hope you will check out my other tutorials. If you have any questions about this tutorial or any of my other tutorials, you can contact me at bloomingknitter@gmail.com or on Ravelry as bloomingknitter. Thanks so much for watching. Bye.